Let me take you back to your tenure when Manish Tiwari and the Congress were in power, and Manish Tiwari was the INB minister. You were a mute spectator to Prime Minister Modi's interview being edited. Why didn't you? And you said it was an interference in operational autonomy. Why didn't you resign then?
I had objected to it in writing, on WhatsApp. I came to know of it much later. As I say, all regimes insulate themselves. I came to know of it through Twitter. My fallout with Mr. Tiwari on that account, which came out in many papers, I'll send you the headlines, because what I am saying is something that I can prove. That suddenly he discovers autonomy, which is a nice way of putting things. That there's a fight between minister and secretary on this score, minister and CU on this score. I had put in my objection. I had said what I had to say. And a certain amount of it was reported. Not all, but a certain amount of it is reported and is there on record. So I refute it right at the beginning.
But my question is, why didn't you resign then?
Oh, then I had to resign at every step. I had differences with Mr. Tiwari going on for 1.25 years. So every step does not mean a resignation. And incidentally, if you want to ask me about this resignation, let me tell you, I've gone on record by saying that I felt very uncomfortable after a year when I found that I was being bypassed in most decisions. So when I felt very uncomfortable about all this, it's all there on record. This was 1 year after Mr. Tiwari's regime had gone, and 1 year. And 1 year was enough of a time.
It was actually 2 years because Mr. Modi took over in 2014.
No, no, no,
You
no.
resigned end of 2016.
I'm clear. I had expressed my unhappiness after a year. Just after a year. My minister was Mr. Arun Jaitley, God bless him, a very tactful person who counseled that I sort of learn to take things a little more lightly, a little more reasonably. He said, "Yeah, you had this problem with Manish also. You seem to have problems with everyone.